All right, Gregory, we are back. Let's talk a little Houston Astros and tell me why they should face serious consequences if it's proven they stole signs.
I mean, let's look at it this way. Everybody looks for that slight edge in sports. You see, like, there's a difference in, you know, I guess stealing a sign as the guy who's standing on second base. You see it in a Little League World Series. You see it in that type of thing where they're giving signals when there's a man on second and a pitch is coming or being called. I mean, there's a difference in, you know, tugging a jersey on a passing route. It's cheating technically, but it's nothing that's super heinous. It's just trying to get a competitive edge. What the Astros have done, from what it sounds like, is basically set up a network of cheating using cameras and all sorts of different things with signals and just completely rigged the deck for themselves. I mean, I think they were the best team at home this season. And if that system's set up in Minute Maid Park, or I think it's still Minute Maid Park, if it's set up like that, I mean, it's so clear and obvious and blatant that it's just disgusting. Like, you don't – I'm all for a competitive edge, but to do something like that is so much worse. It's – I don't know what it is. It's like Spygate, really. I mean, and I know people – take Spygate and throw it out the window, but like actively recording somebody's practice and being able to go over the tape and things like that is so much different than if you had somebody just kind of like in there walking around looking at a play. You know what I mean? Like there's something about the technology part of it and using that to gain the advantage that makes this feel so much worse than another type of scandal. I mean, plus they won a World Series doing this.
As did those New England Patriots. And what was the Patriots' punishment?
Nothing.
Right, because this is the kind of thing, for better or worse, that's tacitly accepted in sports. You know, if there's a really good article on it in The Athletic about this, and there's a comment from a major league manager that says it's an issue that permeates through the entire league. And it happens because the league has done a very poor job of policing or discouraging it. Look, do they set up rules? Yes. But the Major League Baseball hasn't punished anyone since 2017 for sign stealing. And it happens in every single game. In every single game. Maybe not to the extent that of what we're talking about, but it happens all the time. Like, who cares, honestly? Like, how are you going to go back and retroactively punish this team? This is like taking the Heisman Trophy and a national championship away from, well, I guess they didn't win the national championship, but taking the Heisman Trophy away from Reggie Bush back at USC. It means nothing. They still won. Who cares? Move on. Fix the policies. Move forward with rules that are actually enforced. And the past is what it is. You're not rewriting any of it.
And I honestly don't think rewriting the past is the way to punish a team in this situation. I think you have to hurt them monetarily now, and you have to affect future draft picks and draft considerations. Those have to be the way that
baseball draft picks. Oh boy.
Oh, you know what I mean. Foreign player money, international pool money, that sort of thing, Chris. And a large fine. I think there has to be something to that. To steal things electronically makes it feel like such a bigger scandal and a bigger thing. You're gaining something that to the naked eye. Like, I don't care. You have somebody in the bullpen stealing signs, as long as they're not using binoculars and they're able to figure something out. Sure, 100% fine. I would consider that part of the game. But when you're using other methods, something like a camera or something that is setting you up and giving you that edge, it's really major cheating. And nobody cares about taking away a title. You could put asterisks, give me the Bonds thing. The Louisville Cardinals never won the national championship, and they never beat Michigan and Spike Albrecht. Get out of here with all that. I don't care. Obviously. Like, nobody's going to forget that. Nobody forgets when the NCAA takes away titles or awards and all that stuff. It's dumb. Trying to rewrite history is stupid. But affecting their future, I think, is something that has to happen.
Okay, so here's the issue. How do we prove unequivocally that this happened? Because in order to do that, this was handled the wrong way. you know, we have four guys from that 2017 team, and I don't, to my knowledge, and correct me if I'm wrong, we have no evidence that anything has happened post 2017. We can assume, but we don't. No one has claimed for sure, right?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Okay, so we're talking about guys like Mike Fiers in 2017, who was one of the guys who came out and said they were stealing signs. The only evidence of this is a claim from a former disgruntled player who was let go by the team. There's no way to catch them. If he wanted to do something and affect change, he should have gone quietly to Major League Baseball, and then Major League Baseball can look into it as this is still going on. But by coming out publicly, especially after the season is over, then the Astros can just change everything immediately. So the point is, we will never, ever, ever, ever know whether or not it happened definitively. This is he said, she said to the umpth degree, and there is no way to prove it.
I mean, didn't they say that there were signals with whistling and then banging of a trash can and audio? I mean, you can match that up to the types of pitches that are being thrown. And of course, it's not 100%. That's absolutely how they did it. But it's certainly a part of proof that you can potentially use. I mean, listen, I don't think that the way that Mike Fiers went about this, if you're really trying to call an organization out, I don't necessarily think it was the smartest way to do this, because I think it opens up a lot of questions and a lot of ways to sort of mask what was actually done. But I certainly think that there's something when you go back and look at these games that were played at home that it can certainly at least partially be confirmed, if not, you know, like three quarters of the way confirmed.
Yeah, that just doesn't hold up for me, though. Three quarters of the truth is still not the truth. You know, there is no way to say unequivocally that this happened or it did not happen. Yep. Anything we're going to see, any sound we're going to hear, can be chalked up to coincidence.
A coincidence every time somebody throws an off-speed pitch?
Well, it's not an off-speed pitch. It's a change-up, for the record. So let's get your stuff correct. The banging on the dog, that was a change-up. But look, I mean, how do you prove it? How do you prove that's not ambient sound from the stadium? Because I don't know if you know this, but stadiums are noisy.
Of course they are. But you want to tell me in other sports and other scandals that we've always had 100% definitive proof? Was Deflategate 100% definitive proof? Why is every scandal the Patriots? What is going on?
That's true.
Was Barry Bonds 100% definitive proof? Did he ever test positive for anything? I don't remember the year-long ban of Barry Bonds ever kicking in for steroid use, but that's widely considered one of those types of things. I mean, to have the idea that a league needs 100% definitive proof to levy some sort of, you know, penalty for this is almost insane to ask. There's only certain times where definitive proof even actually exists in these situations. Pete Rose, definitive proof. Alex Rodriguez, definitive proof. The guy failed tests. I mean, those are definitive proof things in baseball. But there's other scandals that have never had the full, you know, we figured it out answer. And the league still punished people.
Yeah, sure, they have punished people. But guess what? This is an instance where definitive proof could have easily came. If this is true, and he is not just angry at a team that let him go, then he could have gone to the league, and they could have, you know, audited the games, and you could have proved that it was going on in real time. But this is, like I said, it's he said, she said. I like the phrase butthurt former player who's just has an axe to grind against an organization. Did stealing signs happen? Probably. It like I said, happens in every single game. Every single one doesn't stop the fact that it's going to happen in the next game either, or the game after that, or the game after that. We have stuff in baseball all the time, and at the end of the day, nothing ever happens. Look at the Red Sox thing. Nothing came of that. You know, Manfred even said that it happened without the knowledge of the ownership or front office. Baseball wants to protect its teams. It's not going to take a giant steaming dump on a World Series champ.
You know what's hilarious? You said look at the Red Sox thing, and baseball's so irrelevant, I don't even know what you're talking about. Like, I don't even know.
The use of electronic equipment against the Yankees. Sure. Again, and guess what? No one cares. My point exactly. It's baseball. No one gives a shit.
That is true. Nobody does care because it's baseball. But I still don't think that that means, well, nobody's going to care, so we don't have to give any sort of, you know, we don't have to come up with any sort of ruling or fair punishment or anything like that. To me, there's a difference in gamesmanship, which stealing signs has always been a gamesmanship thing. Jesus. Mm-hmm. That's always been part of it. I remember Mick Billmeyer, the bullpen coach of the Phillies, being suspended and the Phillies being fined for stealing signs from the Citizens Bank Park bullpens in center field, several years ago. I mean, these things happen. Guys get caught. And punishments have to be levied. And this is something serious because you're talking about a team that statistically and was just dominant at home this season. If it did go on the entire season, you're talking about playoffs, playoff positioning. You're talking about seeding. You're talking about just the number of wins overall. I mean, how much did they win their division by? I know it was a significant amount. And they clinched home field advantage.
They did. And guess what? Here's what it comes down to is, even if they're stealing signs, they still have to execute and win games. Does it give them a competitive advantage? Absolutely. But that system was allegedly halted prior to the postseason. It happened only in home games. And the Houston Astros won Game 7 on the road in Los Angeles. They had to actually be able to win games, Gregory. They were good enough to win the World Series.
Of course they are. They have a ton of talented players.
Yeah, exactly. Who cares?
But how do you force Game 7? You have to win 3 games before that. And how many of those games are at home? I don't remember the series. I was in the middle of having a kid during this particular World Series because I remember watching Game 7 at the hospital the day Felicity was born. So it's tough. It's tough for me to remember exactly what went down during that World Series. But it's a situation where it's like impossible for me. It's impossible for me to not think that there's going to be a punishment regardless, and that there should be a punishment, because if you're doing these types of things, you're getting a competitive advantage that not everybody can get because you're using some sort of technology, whether it's a camera, whether it's whatever it is. It's just too much in this situation. And I understand you have to be good. That's what baseball is. That's why when you talk about like steroids, I could take all the steroids I want. I still can't hit a ball 450 feet 73 times in 162 games.
Like, there's only one way to find out.
Listen, I'm down.
This is going to be a really interesting video segment for Underdog moving forward. I can tell you what happened in that 2017 World Series. Dodgers won Game 1, Astros 2, Dodgers 3, Astros 4, Dodgers 5, Dodgers 4, Astros 5, Dodgers 6, Astros 7. So it was literally an every other game situation.
Say who won Game 1 again?
It was Dodgers, Astros, Astros, Dodgers, Astros, Dodgers, Astros.
Right, so L.A. had home field advantage, which means Game 2, 3, and 4 were played in Houston, and they won Game 2 and 4. Yeah, three, 4, and 5. 3, 4, and 5.
They won 3 and 5. They split.
I mean, they didn't split. They won 2 out of 3 at home.
Ugh. Look, proves nothing to me. Until you can show me unequivocally video of them using video, then I'm not taking it seriously. I think this was stupid. I think this is a situation where change could have actually been affected if it was real, but we will never know. And because of that, I'm not inclined to believe what some angry ex-player once said.
Yeah, but it's not like Fiers has been out of the league since then. I mean, he was the ace for the A's this year. A playoff team or almost playoff team.
Yeah, and he was let go by the Astros in 2017.
But he's still making millions of dollars. The bitterness thing doesn't necessarily play.
Oh, you're crazy. You don't think that guys who are this competitive get angry when they're not retained by an organization. That's a slap in the face.
Be better.
Agreed. And be better at catching people who are allegedly stealing signs.
Listen, I do agree. You need a decent amount of proof, but I don't think it's too much for me. If you win the World Series and they have this system, and if it's proven that they have used this, like, some sort of technology, I need punishment, Chris. I need retribution.
I need proof that it happened.
Well, hey, like you said, we may never know.
We will never know. There's no may. We will never know unequivocally whether or not it happened or not.
Once they invent time travel, Chris.
Look, okay, time travel, at least I'm never going to invent it, because I did the thing where I say, okay, if I ever invent time travel, I'm going to come back to exactly this moment. That tells me that I'm never going to invent time travel, so I don't have to worry about it moving forward. I do want to talk about, we just talked about the Astros and the Dodgers. They just so happened to be the top two teams in the odds on Bovada to win the World Series in 2020. Astros +5, Dodgers +6. First of all, do you think these odds are about to change?
Yes.
And secondly, where's your money going to go on the 2020 World Series?
I think the Astros odds are going to change significantly, because I think that people are going to lure Garrett Cole away from there. I think that the money is going to be too overwhelming.
He's going to be an angel. He might as well already be an angel.
I hate that you're saying that, but that's fine. I'd like to have some hope, Chris.
No, he's not. Garrett Cole is from California. He went to high school in California. He went to UCLA. He's going to come back home to play in California. Now,
Chris, why are you ruining my Thursday? I was excited.
I ruin your Thursday every week by dominating you.
I think the Astros odds are certainly going to change. I like the Dodgers again to go back. I mean, all they need to do is get rid of Kershaw, fill up with some picks and some money, and maybe get a little bit in return, and revamp a little bit of the pitching staff. Might as well get rid of Kershaw and sign Cole.
Do you have Clayton Kershaw thoughts, Greg?
Chris, we did this on the show.
That's what I was referencing. I think Cole's an angel. I think Strasburg goes back to the Nationals. And if I'm going to put my money on this right now, I'm going to say Zach Wheeler and Cole Hamels to Philadelphia.
Ooh, Cole Hamels. The 39-year-old Cole Hamels?
I'm not saying it's a big signing. I'm just saying I think that's what's going to happen.
A la Jamie Moyer, Chris?
I mean, first of all, if we could still get Jamie Moyer production from what Moyer produced in Philadelphia, I think you would take that every day. But, Wheeler's going to be a gamble. He's going to get paid a ton. Great stuff. Erratic. Has had injury issues.
Don't ever bet against Zach Wheeler. I'm telling you. There are certain things that I learned in my long life.
Gamblers Anonymous.
Yeah, exactly. There's certain things you don't bet on. Whenever I would go against Zach Wheeler, never win. I don't know why he would pitch the game of his life every single time. The other thing, and I know we're running long in this segment, never bet against the Florida Panthers or the Dallas Stars. They're the two teams. It's a terrible idea. I'm telling you. I mean, just the other night, the Boston Bruins were up 4-0 going into the third period.
What are the Boston Bruins?
Huh?
What are the Boston Bruins?
Yeah, NHL, it exists.
That's the one with the sticks in the ice?
Yes. They were up 4-0 going into the third period, promptly blew a 4-goal lead, and then proceeded to lose in a shootout to those Florida Panthers. Never bet against the Panthers. Never bet against the Dallas Stars, Chris. It's a way of life.
All right, well, I don't care about that at all, but I will ask you this follow-up. What happens if these Stars play the Panthers?
That's a stay-away game if I've ever heard of it. I don't even know if they put up a line for that game.
Just don't worry about it. Just save your money.
At least not my household. Yeah.
You put up your own lines to your house.
In my gambling book, that I'll keep the line down. No, that's all. That's off the board.
You had just admitted to some things that are illegal in the United States.
That's just hypothetical. First of all, I don't have any money. I couldn't. I couldn't run my own bookmaking operation.
You gotta, you're digging yourselves into a deeper hole. You need to stop talking about being a bookie.
Chris, I promise you, I don't have any money. So feel free to come find out.
All right, no, wait a second. Okay, so just to recap the last minute of what's gone on in this show, and this is somehow a Houston Astros segment. What you did is basically you made allusions to being a bookmaker, and then you dared the IRS to come get you.
No, what happened is I said it's off the board in my household, meaning I don't bet on it because it's an impossible game to predict with those two teams that I never seem to get right. And then you said, oh, the odds of your household. And then I made a joke about my house having a book attached to it, which is not anything anywhere near serious or even monetarily possible.
Agree to disagree.
Your misinterpretation made it seem like I now am some sort of criminal mastermind.
You're the one that keeps talking.
Now, listen. I'm going to have you wrap the segment up before you try to twist my words into something that isn't actually real.
I don't think it matters. We're not going to get a third segment. You're going to be in jail by the third segment, Craig. This thing, it's over for you. You're going to watch your upcoming child grow old in prison.
I don't know if that's the case, but we'll see.
All right, we got to go. We're going to figure out what the hell just happened, take a quick break, and we'll be right back.